guys, welcome to another Four Realms of Chaos video. Thank you guys for watching. This is going to be a tutorial on how to paint an Aegis defense line. We're doing an Icarus Las Cannon and a comms relay. So if you guys like the video, please remember to subscribe by clicking the little Cthulhu annotation in the top right and thumbs up. First off, you want to spray these guys with a matte black spray paint. And I'll bring you guys back after this step. Okay, we're back from outside. So I sprayed this black. And the spray paint I used was this Krylon Rust Protector Flat Enamel Spray. There's a bunch of different types. You can use the Games Workshop one, works perfect. So for the first step for painting this Aegis defense line, you're gonna wanna dry brush this black with a metal color. So here I'm gonna use this Folk Art Metallic Paint, but if you really want to use some good stuff, the Citadel Lead Belcher, or bolt gun metal, one of those works perfect. So next, we are going to use a dry brush of Runefang Steel. Okay, here you can see the metal is taking shape. We're done the step. It's a lot brighter. Next, I'm going to dry brush in certain areas this brass scorpion color for a bit of copper. I like there to be like a bit of, you know, like age to it, so that adds some wear and tear of the battle. And we'll come back after that step. So this is the effect after you use the bronze. You can see it's just more like highlights to it, gives it more depth. Okay, so next we're gonna do some oxidization using a teal color, which is this Sotek green, and an orange, which is this blazing orange. And the new line of paint is, I think, some troll slayer. So to get this oxidization effect, you're gonna put in the paint and kind of poke at the specific spots you want. Not really brushing, you're gonna poke at it. It lets it look speckled, which is good. After this teal coat, you're gonna do the same thing of some orange in fewer spots, just right on top of it. Okay guys, I am done the oxidization step. Basically that's what you do. You do some teal, orange speckles, basically like that. Next we're going to do some details, as in the eagle flags of the Imperium right here. So I'm going to base it with a light gray, and then I'm going to use a white to pick out the details. So that will be the next step. Okay, so now that we're done the white eagles, that's how they turned out. I am going to use a Screaming Skull to paint all the skulls on them, like right there, and on this one, and there's a bunch of them, as you can see, like all over here, there's skulls. And just to change it up a little bit from just metal, we're gonna make them bone colored. Okay, so for now we're done with the skulls. There is it layered. We're gonna do like a wash stage at the end, but until then we're going to do some wires. So wires, you can do blue or red, whatever you choose. Some people like to keep it silver. I like to add colors. So this wire right here, and other wires like it without the bumpiness to it, like this. We're going to do a base of, okay, so you're gonna use base Caldor Sky, and then you're going to highlight it with Techless Blue. Okay, so for highlighting, you don't wanna go over everything you've done with the Caldor Sky. You wanna go over like parts of it. So you wanna go from like here to there, on all parts, basically the middles. So next we're gonna do the light stage. So we're gonna do all these like spotlights yellow, and the lights on this one right there, and also here and here. So for that, you can base with a like a brown Balor or Balor Brown is a good dark yellow base. And after that, we're gonna highlight it with this Uriel yellow, or just a brighter yellow color. Okay, so we are done two steps of the yellow. As you can see, the lights are highlighted in the middle. All the spotlights are done. Over here, those are done. That's done. Next, we're going to use Hexos Pale Sun, and we're gonna use a small dry brush, like so. So we're gonna dry brush messily around this yellow over here, over here. It's okay if you get it on the silver. It's gonna be like a glowing effect, and I'll take you back when we're done that. So we're done with the glow effect. It's brightened up on the edges near the metal. It's not too noticeable, but it's good enough. It's a nice quick effect, looks good. You can see it on the skull, the spotlight, and over here. So even though you get it on a bit of the metal like that, still fine, you don't need to fix it up. Okay, if you guys want a little bit extra, you can add some brass scorpion or another bronze color to specific spots you wanna like just stand out, like that part up there, the coils. I did the nuts and bolts copper for this glass can. I did the coils at the front. And yeah, so now we're just on the fix-up stage. Next, I'll be applying washes, and I'll show you what type I'm gonna use in a sec. Okay, so this is the results you get after putting the wash. It is a simple brown wash. You can use Agrax Earthshade. If you water it down, it's probably better. You can also put some washes on the blue wire. You can use a blue wash, a black wash, your choice. Okay, we've now reached the end of the video. I'm gonna show some pictures after of close-up parts of this Aegis Defence Line. I hope you guys liked the video and found it helpful. So if you guys liked the video, please remember to thumbs up and subscribe by clicking the little Cthulhu annotation in the top right with the rockin' guitar. And that brings you to our channel, where you can just hit that little sub box and be informed of all our future videos. To visit our website, search www.fourrealmsofchaos.com for more information on painting quotes and example pictures. So thank you guys for watching, enjoy the pictures, and rock on!